Hello everybody. Under LTspice version 17, it's not quite as simple to record the or to add a new model as it has been in the previous versions, so I thought a quick video about that might be useful. So it's a couple of stages and a bit of preparation we have to do first. So let's create a couple of directories. Under Documents folder, you will see you have an LTspice 17 folder, and it has library examples, and under lib it has these three directories. Now if you go to your C drive under Windows and you go to Program Files and LTC LTspice 17, you'll get library file as well, and you get the same directory structure. These are locked and you cannot add new components to this. These will probably get overwritten when you do an update to a newer version of LTspice. So what we want to do is go back to our Documents folder, go to LTspice 17 library, and these you can add to and they will be saved. So first of all, go to your subdirectory, contributor. Now in this case I want to add one from Fuji, so create a new folder, call it Fuji. Fuji, and it is now a blank empty folder. Then we also have to go to the symbols table, and in here, since I'm going to be adding an IGBT, I want to add an IGBT folder, so new folder, IGBT, and then that's created. So those are the directories you need to create. Then you need to go and download, go to your where you downloaded your device, and in my case I want to add this device, so copy that model from Fuji and I'm going to put it into Documents, LTspice, Library, Subcircuits, Contributed, Fuji, and I'm going to paste it in here. Done. Now I'm going to open this and you will see that this is the device made by Fuji, and it has the subcircuit name which is here, which fortunately is the same name as the library. So let's put that aside for a minute. So we created that. Now if you now go to LTspice, and you need to open and go to symbols. We're going to create a symbol for it now. Fortunately, and there's an IGBT that has been drawn by somebody in LTspice already, which is called NIGBT. There's a positive version of PIGBT as well, but for the sake of this we're going to have NIBGT. And left click and drag, you'll find your model. Now the important bit here is that we're going to edit its attributes, and you can see that they are only a few of them we didn't find. So first of all, since this is a subcircuit model from Fuji, I'm going to make that an X. Then the model itself. Yeah, okay. Go back to your file that you opened. And we're going to paste that in there. We also have to paste it in there. And then we're going to go and call it the Fuji, oops, Fuji models. Okay, now we have to create, we've got to go and get the, to put the, we've got to put the Spice model directory, the whole directory, plus the file name in here. So if we go back to Explorer, then that's the directory name. So I'm not sure how to get the whole thing. So I'm going to get the path and keep sane. Put the thing in quotes, do the double quotes, and get the, yeah, so you get that right. Paste that in there, and now we're going to do. We're going to go and get the folder or file name. And we'll add that to the end of the path. And that should do the job. You might notice now that it's changed to U, that the device name is here. Now, important. This is an NIGBT, so if we create a schematic, you'll see it's called an NIGBT assembly. We don't want to save it there, we want to save it into our own directory as the FGW whatever. So we'll go back to IGBT and we'll change the name. Since we just copied it from the other device, we'll do another directory. So that's the device name now, and now it's changed to the proper one, and we should be ready to use it. If we now go to draft, and we go to create, add a device to it, or create a new schematic, you'll see that IGBT is now here. If you double click it, then it tells you it's a FUGI model. And there's your device that you've just added. Click on OK, park that into your drawing, and we are going to do a test run here just for the operating point, since that's simple, and it works. You get some results. The machine doesn't complain, or LTspice doesn't complain. So that's how you do it. It's not all that difficult, you just got to get the steps right, and off you go. And the nice thing about it, it now works in exactly the same way as, let's say, we added a diode. And if we run this, it gives me the diodes and the IGBT model diode details. So we don't have to add .library and .includes and all the rest. It's just the device is now present in LTspice 17. Thank you, everybody. I hope that's useful. Give me a like or whatever you please if you find this useful. Thank you. See ya.